NBC 15 News at 11 starts now.
Now at 11, a mystery in Wanakee where the FBI is conducting an investigation inside this home.
Plus, a Madison woman is facing first-degree homicide charges after a domestic stabbing incident.
And Subway pitchman Jared Fogle expected to plead guilty to allegations of child porn and having sex with children. Hello and good morning, everyone. I'm Christine Bellport.
And I'm Ashley Matthews. We have one more day to keep that umbrella handy. And it's a little cold outside.
Never mind the umbrella. Bust out the turtlenecks.
I know. I had to go grab a jacket for this afternoon.
It's crazy. And I thought I had enough meat on my bones to keep me warm through winter. Brian, what say you about this fall-like weather?
It is definitely rather chilly outside. I was a little shocked as I came to work as well. But hey, at least we did pick up some much-needed rainfall as we've worked through the past 24 hours. On the order of 1 to 3 inches, even a little bit more in the portions of eastern Grant County. And of course, this is great news as we were running around 3 inches below normal as we kicked off the week. Now, right now, SkyTracker HD, of course, has the cloud cover. There's not a lot of rain out there, but we'll keep the drizzle and sprinkle chance in as we head through today. Also, those cool temperatures, just 61 degrees in Madison, the same from Lone Rock down through Mineral Point and Monroe. It's actually a little bit warmer near the lakeshore, Milwaukee, comfortably into the 70s. Now, compared to yesterday, of course, we're running 10 to 15 degrees cooler, and we're going to have some gusty winds this afternoon as well. That'll make it feel even cooler as we struggle to see any sunshine really at all as we head into the afternoon. Look for high temperatures, likely not even into the 70s, upper 60s as we work into the afternoon and evening hours. Now, there is some end in sight. It includes some sunshine and temperatures back into the 80s. I'll let you know when those arrive coming up in a few minutes. Christine?
Brian, thank you. New at 11, a mysterious situation in Wanakee where the FBI is conducting a search on an apartment. It's happening inside here, this apartment building on Willow Road. Authorities say the search is part of an ongoing investigation. Now, a woman who lives there told NBC 15 the FBI showed up around 6 this morning. She said the FBI told her she was not in any danger. Right now, no other details have been released. Also new at 11, the Wisconsin Department of Justice has moved to dismiss a long-standing lawsuit from 2011 that claims state legislative district lines were drawn to help Republicans. The lawsuit filed by a group of Democrats asked that the map's boundaries be thrown out. Attorneys, though, for the DOJ argue that no standard exists for measuring the so-called burden of a gerrymander, what it places on the right to legislative representation.
A Madison woman is facing a first-degree reckless homicide charge. Police say 25-year-old Sierra Finkley was arrested yesterday afternoon after a 31-year-old man was found stabbed outside an apartment on Moreland Road. He died at the hospital a short time later. Officials say the pair had been involved in a separate incident earlier that day when the man had tried to run over Finkley and a child with his car. Police say the man had a history of domestic abuse. One of the men connected to a weekend stabbing and shooting in Beloit has been arrested. It happened early Sunday morning outside the Turtle Tap Bar and Grill. Three people were shot and a fourth was stabbed. Terry T. Mac Vance was arrested as a participant in that fight. Police are still looking for Rashawn Burnett and Andy Manman Davis, who they believe are the shooting suspects.
The funeral for the construction worker who died at this site downtown for construction will be held Friday. 25-year-old Chris Lord was installing wood trusses on the new apartment building on Webster Street when he fell about 60 feet and died. Lord was supposed to be married this Saturday. He was also a volunteer firefighter for the Lodi Fire Department. The National Weather Service has confirmed an EF1 tornado did indeed touch down in Walworth County. The tornado yesterday is believed to have touched down in the town of Lyons, which is just north of Lake Geneva. Authorities responded to a small industrial park in this area and found several damaged buildings and trees. Thankfully, though, no injuries were reported. And police say heavy rain was a factor in a crash on Madison's south side. A car drove into a home on the 2900 block of Traceway Drive around 7 last night. The driver hydroplaned, losing control, and it caused his car to go airborne. The driver and his dog were treated for non-life-threatening injuries. Now, someone was inside the home at the time. They were not injured.
Happening around the nation, firefighters in central Washington state are hoping the weather does not worsen conditions today as they battle a raging blaze in between Seattle and Spokane. More than 50 structures there have burned down and 1,500 people were forced to evacuate their homes. NBC's Leanne Gregg is in Washington with all the details.
Today, there's concern about a return of strong winds, which could move the fire quickly and erratically. Officials here say that this region is still at risk. There are hundreds of structures that potentially are threatened. The National Guard has moved in, and they're among the 1,000 people working to protect the homes. The air attack has been key. That will continue today with dozens of drops an hour. Firefighters have also been setting controlled burns to try and direct the fires to the burned out areas where there's little fuel. 95 wildfires burning out of control across the West, including one in California that's threatening the town of San Luis Obispo north of Los Angeles. In Oregon, more than 25 homes have been destroyed. In Idaho, that number is close to 40. So many fires that officials are talking with firefighters all the way in New Zealand and Australia to help, along with the U.S. military and prison inmates expected to join in the fight. From Chelan, Washington, I'm Leanne Gregg, NBC News.
In other national news, former Subway spokesman Jared Fogel is expected to plead guilty today to possessing child pornography and traveling to have sex with minors. Federal prosecutors say the 37-year-old traveled from Indiana to New York City to have sex with a then 17-year-old girl at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel. According to court documents, the same girl claims she was paid for sex on at least three occasions when she was 16. Prosecutors say Fogel also received child pornography from the former executive director of his charity. Federal agents seized computers and DVDs from Fogel's home back in July.
Around the world, Oscar Pistorius will not be released from prison this Friday. Earlier this week, he was approved to be moved to house arrest. But authorities say Pistorius should serve a full 10 months of his sentence before even being considered for release. He was sentenced to 5 years for killing his girlfriend, Reva Steenkamp, Valentine's Day in his home in South Africa in 2013. Well, the Bangkok shrine where 22 people were killed in a bombing this week reopened today as police released a sketch of the man they say carried out the attack. NBC's Ian Williams reports now from Bangkok.
The shrine was reopened early this morning, and since then, there's been a steady stream of worshippers, the devout, the curious, and those just wanting to pay respects to the victims of Monday's horrific bombing. This is one of the city's most important shrines, good fortune it represents. There are flowers all along the fence here, this table weighed down by tributes. They're fast running out of places to put them. They are making hasty repairs. The main bomb crater here has now been filled in with cement, but the mangled fence behind still shows the impact of that explosion. A manhunt is now underway, but still no information as to the whereabouts of the man the police believe to be the bomber. The youngster in a yellow T-shirt captured on that grainy security camera video released last night. The police say they doubt he was acting alone. He was probably part of a network. The security here today is tight but reasonably low key. The authorities keen to give the impression of a return to normality, but this is a city on edge. It's a tense place and likely to remain that way as long as the bomber is at large. Ian Williams, NBC News, Bangkok.